from the managing committee of KCA. As your president, it is my proud privilege to bring you a webinar on a topic as important to us as the life itself. Today's webinar is all about a will, and it gives an insight into how one can go about writing a will. This webinar is the 12th in a knowledge series as we focus on bringing experts in many fields face to face with our members. And please make the utmost use of this opportunity and direct all your questions, however simple they may seem to the moderator, who will pose them to the presenter. Our social media groups are buzzing with activity. With the addition of the Telegram members and the Telegram business groups, in addition to our WhatsApp and Facebook groups as well, members can now post all their peer-to-peer business messages to network more effectively for free. With the addition of 73 new members, our membership base now stands at 1,800. With the inclusion of two youth members into the managing committee, we will now focus on more youth programs for education, leadership, music, and fine arts. We will revamp our website to reflect the dynamism of our community. The enthusiasm of my team knows no bounds. And together we shall grow in strength, reaching out to all our sister organizations in the FKCA, CONCAB, and KE, whose members join us in this webinar to ensure that our community takes its rightful place in the social fabric of our nation. I look forward to your continued support and participation in all our initiatives, and you will find them all in the eco bar, which is updated regularly. Don't forget to log in and bring yourself up on the happenings within our community. Thank you, and over to our youth member and moderator for this webinar, Viren Perez.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Hilma. A warm welcome to today's webinar session on wills and succession. We are thrilled to have you all here. Thank you for taking the time to spend with us. My name is Viren Perez. I will be your moderator for the evening. A few pointers before we start this session. I kindly request all our viewers to kindly switch off their microphone during this session. I kindly request all our members to switch off their microphone so that our speakers not disturbed during the session. The second thing is, if any of you all have questions that need to be asked to our speaker, kindly type it in the chat box and I shall read them out at the end of the webinar. And Mr. Robinson shall answer all your questions, time permitting. There is also a small survey that will be sent out to each of our viewers on this webinar. So kindly please take a little bit of time to fill out the webinar and send it out to the KCA so that our future webinars can be held with great success. Now, today's webinars, we're going to be talking about wills and succession planning, which is a key practice area which is really overlooked by a lot of people. And to help us with that, we have a very important panelist with us today, our guest of honor, Mr. Robinson D'Souza. He is a legal consultant, a motivational speaker, a lawyer, and a civil servant with over 40 years of experience in handling many portfolios in Karnataka, such as the principal secretary, Karnataka Legislature, Vidhan Sauda. He was also the secretary to our very own Chief Justice of the High Court of Karnataka from 1987 to 1989. He is also the former president and the founder and president of the Toastmasters Club, Bangalore, and the former president of our very own Canara Entrepreneurs. Thank you so much, Mr. D'Souza, for gracing us with this occasion. Now, on today's topic, Mr. Robinson is going to guide us as to why is estate planning necessary? How important is it to make a will? Why should one make a will? And what should the family members do when a person passes away with a will or without a will. I kindly request our members, if you all need to take down any points, please feel free to do so. Mr. Robinson, the screen is all yours.
Thank you very much. Viren, good evening, everyone present. Let me go to
yes, I can hear Dennis. Who's calling me repeatedly. Hello. Yeah, I'm Dennis speaking. Is somebody calling me repeatedly?
No, Mr. Dennis, kindly switch off your microphone, please. Thank you. Mr. Robinson, you can go ahead. Mr. Robinson, your mic is muted.
One second. Are you able to see my screen? Are you able to screen?
Yes.
See my screen?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. What's a will? I'm sure nearly 60% are here participating in this webinar. This question, will, must be bothering. It's very simple. Will is a very simple document. Very simple. Will, it's a legal document. It must specify one's wishes, aspirations, and intentions to pass on his assets. And it will come into effect. It will come into effect. Sorry, something has happened here.
You can just click on the presentation again, Mr.
Yeah, Robinson. Yeah, I'll do it. One second. No, I have to go back, I think. One second, you're presenting to everyone. There is a problem here.
If you can click on stop presenting that you see on top right, and start again after, yeah, it should work.
Can you see the screen?
Now we can, yes.
Yeah. What's a will? Will is a document specifying one's wishes and intentions to pass on his assets after his lifetime. It must be a document. It must contain or reflect the person who makes the will. That person's name is called testator. Testator's wishes and intentions in respect of his properties, which will come into effect only after his demise. One person has posed me a question. Can I make a will on a white paper or on a handkerchief or on a tissue? The answer is yes. One can make his will not only on a white paper, but on a handkerchief also, and also on a tissue. But please don't try it on the last two, handkerchief and tissue. A document written on a white paper becomes legal when it is signed by the testator, the person who makes the will, by the testator, which specifies his intentions, wishes, in respect of the property to come into effect afterwards. How does this white paper becomes a legal document? It becomes a legal document when that testator signs this white paper in the presence of two witnesses who are called attesting witnesses. There must be three persons must be present there, testator, two attesting witnesses. The testator has to sign this white paper, this his will, in the presence of those two attesting witnesses, and attesting witnesses in turn, in the presence of the testator and in the presence of each other, have to attest their signatures. Then this white paper becomes a legal document. Now, when you make a will, your ownership of the property remains unaffected. You don't lose your property at all. You can do anything with that property. You can sell it, mortgage it, or gift it. Though it is covered in the will, only your last will be effective. You can write any number of wills during a lifetime. The last will have only a legal effect. And at the time of your demise, whatever property you have, you possess, you own, and mention in the will, only those properties are covered by your will. Not all those properties which you had mentioned at the time of writing the will, but only those properties which you own at the moment of your demise, though you have mentioned in the will. Ownership is not affected. Let me share with you one incident which happened recently regarding the benefits of will. Why you should write a will? Mr. Shoeswami was a close friend of mine. He was a very rich fellow, inherited lots of property from his parents. He retired as the Deputy Commissioner of Excise in Bangalore. Very noble man. He never smoked and did not touch a drop of alcohol to my knowledge. But at the age of 65, suddenly within a days of 15 days, span of 15 days, he expired on account of cancer. He had written a will. After his demise, both his children, who were in United States, returned to Bangalore, and within 1.5 months, all his property, 5 immovable properties in Bangalore, were transferred to the names of the children without any assets. That's the benefit of the will. If you don't write a will, what will happen? Look at this story, which I am handling. Muscat girl, I call her Muscat girl. She is from Puttur, the place where my wife comes. See, only one child to her parents. Her parents went to Muscat. Father was in a good job, earned a lot, returned to India, purchased immovable property in Puttur, then flats in Mangalore and also in Bangalore, and of course other bank accounts and all. In the meanwhile, his only daughter, he took her to Muscat, got her a job, very good job, and she is working there. Recently, in April, when the parents, somebody please switch off your mic, it's disturbing. Recently, her parents went to see their daughter in Muscat, but unfortunately, they died within a span of 1 week. Both of them died on account of COVID. Now the problem is that father has not written a will. In the Muscat Bank, father has a deposit of nearly 35 lakhs of Muscat currency. The bank has asked daughter to get the succession certificate. In order to obtain the succession certificate, she has to come all the way to India, either to take leave. If it doesn't get a leave, she has to be absent. We don't know how long it will take from the court to obtain a succession certificate. Succession certificate is granted by the court. Then she is not aware of any title deeds of the properties. Since his father was quite rich and had a good lot of assets and money also, he had allowed his relatives to reside in the property Puttur, Mangalore, and also back. Now, the relationship. Just for want of a will. If her father had written a will, all these problems would not have come. And she is a spinster, only child to her parents. What's the use of earning so much money if it can't go to their children? Ask yourself if you are doing this. Dr. Varghese and Mrs. Varghese were working in London as doctors. They also, after earning wealth, returned to India. They purchased a property in Bangalore, an apartment, and also another apartment in Hyderabad. They have 2 children. Son is working and employed and a citizen in the United States. Dr. Varghese, when he went to see his son, he expired in the United States. He had not made a will. Now the problem is they are Hindus. They are gone by Hindu Succession Act. The moment he died, the property is inherited by his wife and two children. Now, some legal document has to be done. Meanwhile, Hyderabad tenant has stopped paying rent. He is not bothered at all because he has come to know that Dr. Varghese, who was the landlord, is no more. Now, to settle the property among them, they have to go for a settlement deed, which has to be registered one document according to the Karnataka rules in Bangalore or in Karnataka, and another registration deed in Hyderabad. Son is in US, widow and daughter are in here. Look at the problems for want of wins. Now, one second. Mr. Gowda, ML Gowda, he was my neighbor, a divisional manager in the syndicate bank. He also did not write a will. He also had two children. Daughter is a dentist in the United States. Son is an engineer there. He died without a will. He had property in Puttur, Sulya in particular, landed property. He had allowed his relatives to look after them. Now his children have settled permanently. They are United States citizens in US. Widow is here, our neighbor. Okay, she is safe. She has a house, she gets pension. She moves on in her life. But Mangalore property, which had been given to their relatives, they wanted that property in their name for a song. And they insisted their children from the United States to come down here to execute the sale deed. During COVID days, both leaving their small kids in United States had to come down and to execute the sale. The relative did not accept even a power of attorney. Now, why people don't execute will? Why they are hesitant? A close friend of mine requested me to help his mother-in-law in Mangalore to write a will. I agreed and I told him, please tell your mother-in-law, ask if she is ready to make a will, then fix a date and time, I'll go there. I went there on the specified date and time. But instead of opening the door, the old lady was peeping through the window and saying, don't come, yanaka, yanaka, to osu, osu, maka moronaka, amorana, maka moronaka, maka vilnaka. This is the attitude of many people. Now, in this presentation, what you will learn? You will be learning, do you need a lawyer to write a will? If I have only wife, I have no children. Should I write a will? All my property will go to my wife. How many of you think so? If you think that entire property in such a case where the couple don't have children, only wife. Wife will get only 50% of your property, 50% of your property. The remaining 50% will go to other relatives as per the section law. And to move on, it's a virtual time. Everything, drafts are available on the Google format. You will be filling up a format at the end of this session, Google format, giving your feedback. Why can't I go take a Google format and write a will? I'll answer that one, the consequences which you can do. Next, why will? Why I can't share my property as per my wish without a will, which you can't do? Then, what's the right age to make a will? Is probate required? I will be answering all those questions in another 45 minutes. Now, let me share with you the second story. Canada Entrepreneurs, it was started about 12 years back in Bangalore. It's a group of Christian business, young business people. We are joined together. And at the end of 2008, we started. There are about more than 350 members now. We do networking. Alex, a medical representative, a neighbor of mine, joined GE. Then on the first day, he asked me, Robinson, is there a cancer specialist amongst you? I said, yes. Dr. Antony Poyce was close by. Then I introduced Alex to Antony Poyce, then came away. About a week later, Alex came to me. Robinson, please help me to make a will. I have a checklist. I gave that checklist to Alex, requested him to fill it up. And he filled it up and came back on the next day itself. He was in a hurry. I didn't understand. Then, after studying that checklist, I prepared a draft as mentioned by him there. Then he cleared it, some changes and all. Then I finalized. And on a Friday, I fixed about 8 p.m. in the night. I told them to come here. The final draft will be ready. Please bring your witnesses. They must come along with you and you can sign. 8 o'clock on the Friday, I waited. Alex did not come, but it was raining. I waited the rain to slow down. After the rain ceased, I contacted Alex. Then he said, sir, they are not willing to come because it's raining. And they say that I can make the will after my return from the hospital. He mentioned to me that on the next day early morning, he'll be getting admitted to Dr. Antony Poyce Hospital. And he continued, sir, you have to help me. I have to sign my will. Without signing the will, I don't want to go to the hospital. Because many of his relations, including his father and brother, elder brother, had died of cancer. And this person was not that well. Then I told him, Mr. Alex, don't worry about it. Every problem has a solution. I'll find out a solution. Then I telephoned Dr. Antony Poyce in the night, explained to him the situation. He also told me that Alex had to has to be admitted next morning. And I requested Antony Poyce, doctor, I'll be sending his finalized will through internet. Please download it, take its copy. And before he is taken to the operation theater, make him to sign that will. You sign as a witness and also request one of your doctors to sign. Both of you have to sign in the presence of Alex, and Alex has to first sign in your presence. They did it. And unfortunately, Alex died within a couple of days in that hospital. Now, what you learn? The will became effective. That white paper became a legal document on the demise of Alex. It was not registered. It was not notarized. No stamp paper, friends, for a will to become a legal document. Only three things I mentioned earlier. Signing by the testator, attestation by two witnesses, it must be written on the paper. That are sufficient. There is no need for registration, notarization, or stamp paper. Testator, two attested witnesses should be present there, but the witnesses should not get any benefits under the will. If any benefits is given to the will be valid, but the benefits would be invalid. They won't get it. Now, sometimes the witnesses can't sign for several reasons. It happened to me last week. I had prepared a will for a teacher in Mangalore, sent the will according to wishes, finalized will to her about 6 months back. Last week, there was a call from her stating that I can't sign. I am sick. It is not possible for me to sign. I want to put my thumb impression. Yes. Last page was changed, mentioning that she is putting her thumb impression instead of signature because he is not capable of putting her signature. And witnesses will attest that they have seen her putting her thumb impression on the papers and on the will, and they have put their signatures thereafter. Now, if the person is sick, there is a special provision in the Registration Act where the sub-registrar will go to the house of the sick person and he can register. If the person is in the hospital, the sub-registrar has to go to the hospital and register. There is a provision under the Registration Act to register such wills. Now, story. There was a lady in Richmond Town. Her son was my friend, a member of the Toastmasters. And this lady requested me to be an executor of her will. A will should have an executor. An executor means an administrator. You have to take the consent of that executor person before making an executor of the will. I agreed. Then later on, there was no connection between us. She did not telephone me. I went abroad to my children, my daughter in Sydney. There I came to know that she had expired. On my return, I contacted my friend, her son, and asked him about the will. And also mentioned that your mom had telephoned me, mentioned me, I'll be the executor of her will. Has she made a will? Yes, Robinson, she has made a will. And we have divided our properties according to the will she mentioned. Then I requested him for a copy of the will. This will she had handwritten by her handwritten, 3 pages will. It was attested by the bank manager and an officer in the bank. That's all. There was no problem at all. And it was settled. See, what we learn, lawyer is not needed. There must be a clear intention. In any language would do. No legal words. That's what that teacher had done, and it was given effect to. But what I learned later on is that, in respect to this Richmond, the teacher's will, Richmond Town will, I call it, 2 years later, a person in Canada came to me. He had a copy of her will. He said that, I am her son-in-law. I have married her daughter. She has not given a pie to my daughter. It's surprising because she loved my wife so much. They used to speak with each other every day, but nothing is given. I told her, see, she has written, your mother-in-law has written her will in her own handwriting. No doubt she has not mentioned it, but it's her intentions. I can't interfere. I can only administer the will, give effect to the wishes of her will, nothing more. But I requested, I suggested him to go and contact any other lawyer regarding this. I can't help you. But he did not go to the court. Now, Alex's case. After Alex's demise, I had been to the Mainz Mass. There, Alex's widow held my hand and took me to a relative and said, this is the person who saved my family. This is the lawyer who saved my family. I didn't understand what she was saying. Because after all, I had done writing a will of Alex. Nothing else. And according to his wishes. But later on, I came to know that Alex had another son. That son had not attended even the funeral of Alex. He was not there for the Mainz Mass also. See, the liberty you get while writing a will, it affords you freedom to choose the beneficiary. You can deprive your own family members the benefits. Or you can give your property to somebody else, whomever you like. You can vary the shares. But if you don't make the will, succession law comes into force. Their beneficiaries are identified. Shares are determined. And all these will go according to the succession law if you don't make a will. Now, in Chikmagalur, this happened. Somewhere about 8 years back, there was one person. He was my friend's grandfather. He had coffee estates and agricultural lands. He died without making a will, leaving behind 5 sons and 2 daughters. The daughters had been given in marriage. Sons, that's a joint family. And I said, he did not make a will. His eldest son was like a Gurkha. He was managing the entire property. As soon as father died, he took control of everything, including managing his 4 younger brothers. And he assigned them different houses, and the life went on. Of course, during that time, all these people were not educated. They were in a village. And at the end of his life, this elder brother distributed, made a will, giving all the properties of his father to his children, not to any of the other 4 brothers. What happened? Which he could not have done it. The moment that father died, my friend's grandfather died, when he did not make a will, succession law had come into force. 1/3 of the property would have gone to the widow, and the 5 brothers should have shared the remaining 2/3. But after a long time, he made a will and the litigation started. What lessons we learn? One can make a will only in respect of his property, not in respect of other properties. Advantages, when you make a will, you have the freedom to distribute your assets to anybody you want. Look at the case of Alex. He wanted to, he disowned, not specifically, but he didn't give any property to one of his sons. And Richmond town teacher, she did not give a paisa to her daughter who was in Canada. Then you have the scope to consider special needs and circumstances. You may have a sick or mentally retarded child or a handicapped child. When you make a will, you have the opportunity to give a little more for that child, because that child or that person will not be able to work, will not be able to earn, and definitely needs a little more share as compared to others. So you have the liberty to give, treat him as a special case, provide him little more. This is available only when you make a will, and avoid possible disputes among the children. Remember what happened to my friend. They had to spend their time, nearly 50 years litigating, and the money they spent. And at the end, when everything was settled to a court decision, it took considerable time, nearly 40-50 years, and the value had depreciated, and they suffered a lot. Now, advantages. One more advantage is, details of your assets and investments are likely to be at one place in one document. If you make a will, it's likely to be if you take care. Even sometimes people forget all those things. Advantages, Shivaswamy told. Shivaswamy, Deputy Commissioner Excise. There was a hassle-free transfer of immovable property. What the children produced was a death certificate, copy of a will, self-declared family tree, and a notarized affidavit. That's all. Within 1.5 months, Katha's investor of 5 properties in Bangalore transferred to the names of the children as per the will, and the son is back in Dallas, continues to work there. Recently, in one case, a Christian case, BBMP insisted upon probate. No. There is a recent High Court judgment saying that in respect of Christian wills, probate is not needed. Despite that, I think Mr. Dr. Advocate, former president of FKCA, is in this now in the webinar. He had a problem like this about a Tahsildar insisting upon a probate. That happened about 10 days back. Christian will does not require probate, and there is a recent decision of the Karnataka High Court to this effect also. Now, advantages. Will overrides nomination. Banks, financial institutions release deposits on the production of a copy of the death certificate and will. That's sufficient. If you have made a nomination, the nominee will be a trustee. Nominee cannot appropriate the entire amount, to which I'll come a little later. To proceed, will overrides succession laws, because it is succession laws will not apply when you make a will. You can make a will as per your wishes, can give anything, your property, as per whatever you decide, something more to some persons in deserving cases. No stamp duty, no registration. Probate, of course, is optional. Registration is also optional. It's your wish. If you register, a little extra benefit advantage, maybe little, very spoonful, because the person will have to go to the sub-register office for registration, and a sub-register will question about the contents of the will and whether the person knows what is written there. That's all. That's one of the advantages you will have. And such a certificate will be unnecessary if you make a will. Now, lessons. When there is no will, you will be overlooking a legal right given to you to distribute your wealth. If there is no will, then your estate, your property, it will be in a state of unrest. Succession law will take over And there is every possibility of a forged will or document surfacing and long court battles, expenses, court expenses, advocates' expenses, waste of time and money, all this stuff when there is no will. Now, at the same time, the value of the property will be depleted. Now, lessons. When you know will, you require a legal aid certificate. Three certificates, either section certificate or letter of instruction. What's legal aid certificate? This certificate is issued by the government, revenue department. Today, now, Karnataka stopped, has given instructions. Legal aid certificate can be issued only to the families of the district government service, not to anybody else. Section certificates have to be obtained from the court, like that Muscat girl. Bank has refused, bank is insisting. Imagine the, her father, more than 35 lakhs of money there. If he had made a joint account, made that bank up so much money, joint with his daughter, she would have drawn it. Now, there are instructions. For section, we have to approach the court. Again, fee, time, legal fee and all will come. This section certificate is issued to collect debts due to the deceased. From the there may be deposits in LIC, deposits in banks, or loans given to somebody else. In respect of that, those, if a person obtains section certificate by applying the court will has to follow a certain procedure for that. A public notice will have to be issued. Then after hearing the parties, it will issue a certificate. On the, that basis, the banks, insurance companies, and others can safely hand over the money belonging to the deceased to the person who has obtained such a certificate, and that's safe. Then the holder of the, now coming to this next letters of administration. If you don't make a will at all, you die without a will, then you have to obtain, approach the court for the grant of letter of administration. If you have a will, you can request for probate. Probate is an order of the court. It's optional. Need not, there is no need, but it's optional. Then in a case of probate, the court will issue its order attesting a copy, accompanying a copy of the will, saying that this is a true copy of the will. Even then, if a person wants to challenge the genuineness of that will, he can challenge. Later administration comes when there is no will. Then legal heads have to approach the court, and court, after a public notice and holding a due inquiry, will issue a letter of administration for managing the properties of the deceased. Dr. Working died about a year back. He was a very prominent doctor in the cantonment area. This person did not make a will, and in respect of his bank account, he did not make any nominations also. No will, no nomination. And last week, the children came to know that he had a certain, he has amounts in the bank. How to get that amount? Can she get an amount? No will, no nomination. Amounts are there in the bank account, SP account of your relation. Is it possible to get that amount? Yes, it's possible now. Let me show you how we can do it. In April 2020, there were 82,025, nearly more than 82,000 crores of unclaimed money, forgotten investments, lost savings. We should have gone to the dear ones, near and dear ones, the legal representatives, the family members of the deceased. These people have deposited those amounts to earn more interest or something. Maybe in the insurance, maybe mutual funds, maybe in the bank, and either they have forgotten or they have died, they have not informed their relatives. 82,000 crores in April 20 to break up. Inoperative SP accounts, 12,000 crores. Matured FTs and other deposits, 4,820 crores. These matured FTs, another matured FTs, 1,600 crores. Here, while purchasing FTs, investing FTs, these people did not tick a column, to make auto renewal entry, as if when the first investment matured, the deposit has stopped earning interest. Just one careless thing, or the bank manager did not advise that person properly. 1,600 crore lying there without earning any interest. Then insurance companies, general insurance, 15,167 crores at the end of April. That money is accumulated. Life insurance, LIC, 7,000 crores plus. Mutual funds, 17,880 crores. Mutual fund dividends. And provident fund, unclaimed provident fund. More than 36,000 crores lying there, unclaimed. Can LRs get this amount? Yes, there is a provision. Dr. Verghese's family contacted me on 12th while I was preparing for this presentation. And I immediately shared those details with them. On 13th, they approached the bank, and bank provided the list of the documents they had to provide. I have shared this material with Harriet and that article. And anybody wants this article, you can approach Harriet or request her. She will distribute the same thing with you. How to get your money back? And another thing you must remember here is there is time to claim these documents. Up to 25 years, it's mentioned in that article. Now, nomination misconception. SP accounts, FDs, insurance, mutual funds. There, the nominee becomes only a trustee. He can't appropriate the entire amount. He is, in other words, a caretaker of that money. It's his duty to distribute that amount amongst the legal heirs of the deceased. That's his responsibility. It applies to shares also. So when you make a will, and in respect of that, those nominated investments, will overrides nomination. PPF. There may be 10 lakhs in the PPF. If you have not made any nomination nor a will, your legal heirs will be entitled only to rupees 1 lakh according to PPF rules. The remaining amount goes to the bank, government. Now, who is competent to make a will? He must be of a sound mind and above 18 years. Should not be a minor. And he should be aware of what he is doing. He should not be intoxicated. No fraud, any force or influence should be brought upon him to make the will. Then the will be valid will. Now, executor is nothing but an administrator. He'll be a representative of the testator. The moment the testator expires, the property vests in the executor, and it is his duty to settle or give effect to the will or distribute the will as per the will of the deceased. He will be responsible to implement the desires, aspirations, and wishes of the deceased. So you have to select a person for you as an executor. He must be trustworthy, and moreover, he should be available. He should have time to help you to give effect to the will. Otherwise, the purpose will be defeated. Now, this I mentioned, obtaining prior consent as that Richmond Town lady did. But administrator, the executor may be a beneficiary. You can appoint your own close relative as executor, assisted by someone experienced person. This is not so far as the witness is concerned. He doesn't get any benefit. Then if he refuses to act, or he expires, or he absent, then one has to approach the court, and court will appoint an executor. Now, if you want to change the will, you can write the will any number of times. Only your last will come into effect. But in the meanwhile, if there are minor changes, or if you want to explain something that you have mentioned, you think that earlier thing you have mentioned, there is some confusion. You can clarify it. Or you want to add small things there. Or you want to delete something. you can make a document. That's called codicil, and that is also executed in the same manner of fashion, like the in writing, signed by the testator, and two attesting witnesses. That's called codicil. Now, when do you have to make a fresh will? When there are birth of children or grandchildren, you may get more ideas. You may wish to give your properties, assets to your grandchildren also. When children are, your children are married, death of beneficiary, someone has died and you have to change the distribution pattern, or executor himself has died, or you acquired more properties, or you have disposed of certain properties, in that case also, you can, you will have to go for a fresh will. You may have to go for a fresh will. Now, you have made a will. Your wife died. You marry again. What will happen to the will? Or you make a will when you are a bachelor, or a woman when she is a spinster. You marry. In both these cases, your will becomes void. You will have to write a fresh will. According to the law, the earlier will becomes invalid. Now, when to make a will? Best thing is that when after the age of 35 or 40, ideal, if you are employed and if you have assets. Married, yes, make a will. And early in life, it's better. Early in life means you should be employed, you should have certain properties, then only you can make a will, then only you will find a will. Otherwise, without any properties, making a will, you can make it, but no properties, it will be useless. Early in life is better, because when a will is made at the fag end, when the person is about to die, then it will be doubted. Then it is, that will be challenged, because the relative will say, no, he was not in a fit state of mind to make the will, and somebody after has forced him to make the will, all those complications will come and litigation will start. Remember the present lifespan. According to the research study, if you are 60, you will live another 18 to 18.2 years. If today you are 70, you will be living another 11.6 years. Average life expectancy for a female now is 70 plus, and for a male, it is 68. Somebody has to find out the reason why we live for a lesser period, lesser number of years. I leave it to you. Hey, you have to mute your mic, please. Adrian, I think. Now, regarding this, I've shared the article with Harriet. If anybody wants to see that article, it has it is a lengthy one, about 7 or 8 pages. Very interesting. Now, there is another video which I shared with Harriet today. Age is a mistake. Age is a mistake by Deepak Chopra. He says, there is misconception about aging. He shouts, nobody dies of old age. People die on account of diseases. These diseases are preventable, and we can reverse our age. Age can be reversed. It's quite interesting video. Those who are interested, please request Harriet for a copy of that video. Now, what you can include in the living will, you can put it in the will, or you can make a living will separately. If you make it separate, better. Living will means, if there is no chance of you surviving, you have a very serious disease, you are completely bedridden, and you are in a coma for a long time, you are in a vegetative state, that time, if you make a will earlier, give me liberty to asking the doctors and your family not to put on you, keep you in ICU, and insert tubes and make you live in a vegetative state, then you can empower your family to request doctors to remove, to withdraw those oxygen pipes and the feeding pipes. This happened to B.L. Gowda. He had a heart attack. Then he requested his wife to take him immediately to Sagar Hospital. He was taken there. He was in Sagar Hospital for 22 days. And they spent 24 lakhs, more than 1 lakh per day, just to keep with the tubes. Then his son came from the United States, engineer, observed everything, saw there, and he said, "Doctor, it's enough. Let him die naturally. Don't trouble him. That provision is there in the you can make a living with. Now you can include business, your business will, and digital assets and club membership also, if the club allow, club rules and bylaws allow this one high bequesting the club membership, giving club membership under a will. Now why hesitation? Trust in heirs and children. We trust them. There will be no fight. Without a will, we can settle the matter. This is, then it's time consuming. It's expensive. No, it's not time consuming at all. You have to spend some money. You have to spend. It all depends upon whom you contact and the volume of the quantum of your property and time involved and all. But don't hesitate to make a will. I will just explain to you the absence of a will. What has happened to those several cases I mentioned to you. Now, hesitation, lack of interest. I have no time. I don't have property at all. A person has got property. If he has no property, all right, I think. But normally, when a person is about 50 years old, he has accumulated property. And some think that if they make a will, they die. Like that mother-in-law of my close friend. Now, secrecy. You must keep your will secret. See, when you make a will, it is not final. You can change it anytime. It is open to change. You can write hundreds of wills if you have time. Only the last will be enforceable. That's effective. But keep it secret. You don't know what will happen. There may be change of circumstances. Once you have written the will, there may be change of you want to change it. So if you disclose, mention it to the people, it will be very difficult to change because the people know what they get. And though you have the liberty to change it, if you change it and die, and the other person doesn't know that you have changed it, he say that you have cheated him or you have fooled him. During that time, you will not be here. You will be going up, and your near and dear ones, whom you promised that, you had said that they will get this property or that property, and finally, if they don't get it, they will curse you for their life as cheating or fooling them. Then, if you make a will, if you bequeath something, your staff, POs, those who have benefited, always you must keep it secret. Don't tell them. Or if you disclose to them, since they are the beneficiaries, if you die early, there may be harm to you. Then, even disclosing certain aspects to your family members is dangerous. One person had made a will, only one house. He worked without servant. Two sons. He loved his first son. I don't know why he didn't love his second son. I don't know the person. He gave his son to his eldest son and told his second son also. The second son immediately bet him, took him to a lawyer, forced him, the lawyer, to make a will and got it registered. After that, this person became a total vegetable. Recently, I am handling this case of my secretariat colleague. She is a widow. She has three children. Eldest is a son. The other two are daughters. Daughters are engineers. Son is mentally affected. He gets physical handicapped pension. And if my colleague dies a widow, she gets a part of her pension. What she wanted to do was that house she has, the first floor she has given to first daughter. Second floor she has given to the second daughter. In the ground floor, this widow stays along with her son, mentally retarded son. He has schizophrenia. He's incapable of working. And she gave me the instruction to do. I drafted according to wishes. Her wish is that after a will come into effect only after death. After demise, my son should get the first floor until his lifetime. Until his lifetime. Because that ground floor has two units. One, in one unit, independent unit, he can stay. In other unit, he can rent it out. He will get a little more income. Nice idea. I drafted it. After I sent that draft to her, she shared that one with her daughters, and particularly the first daughter, her second daughter. And immediately she said, no, I want the ground floor. You give him the first floor. Imagine the condition. He is a mentally retarded person. Mother will not be there in the village to come into force. And a sick, mentally retarded person has to go all the way to the upstate to spend his time. We'll have to keep all these things secret. Similar case I had in a Mangalore, a lady wanted a will. I listened to her. Then I thought, no, it's not good if I make a will like that as per her wishes. I tried to explain her because she has five children. She wanted to give all her properties to others. But all her children, five children, are well employed. Four of them are abroad. Even then, I was hesitant. Did not make it for over 1 year. Then she insisted. Robinson, you must make it. I only trust you. It is my property. My husband has given it to me. I have the right. If I don't have the right, who will have the right? Not my children. They're well employed. They're not coming to see me. After that, I agreed. I made a will as per her wishes. It was registered. I insisted that it should be attested by two other witnesses, not any Christian person or family member. They should be outside, known to her. But once the will was registered, I returned to Bangalore. This lady informed her children. Within 1 week, all the five children were in her house. A few of them had not seen her for over 10 years. All of them were there. Saw the will, again took her to the subject office, changed it. This lady, after the children left her, went to their respective places. She fell ill within a week and spent the rest of the time, just 3 months, on a hospital bed. The sin she committed was disclosing her will to her children. What are the precautions you have to take? One, present trend of investments. You don't get hard copies. They're all soft copies. If you don't record that details or take hard copies of them, they don't provide you. It's your responsibility. Imagine you lose, you forget. Something happens to a laptop. Then you lose all the details. If you die without maintaining the record, disclose your children, all your records will be gone. Your investments are gone. Try to obtain soft copies. Keep a record of that. Now, for a Vijay Bank officer, I had made a will. He had some properties. And he had rented them out. His wife was also in a bank. As he accumulated some wealth, he built a house in his native place, saying that it will be a resort. Whenever we want to go there, we can. Myself, my children can go and stay in my resort, he used to say. But I insisted upon, show me the documents, title deeds. He took time, but then he said, no, I could late then, I'll bring next time, we'll make the will. He made a will, it says. I don't insist upon, unless I have doubt. I insist upon documents, legal dates or not. I trust the clients. He died. Now the children, wife, they are struggling to locate the title deeds. They don't find. And that resort is in the possession of his relatives. They are not also helping them. See what has happened. Forgotten investments. In April, I mentioned about it, 82,000 crores stagnant in Right, because they did not make a will. They have not left any documents. Preserve all documents, investments, fixed deposits, mutual funds, shares, etc. That is a safe place. That is a safe place. And one trustworthy person in your relation, maybe your wife, maybe someone you can totally trust, must be aware. Give a set of copies to him. Now, precautions. Bank accounts, FDs, make it joint names. Payable to either a survivor. Remember, Muscat girl. Then, your names, addresses, try to link them to Aadhaar and PAN cards. Self-medicate. All of you believe self-medication is dangerous. This applies to wills also. Don't go to Google. Don't try to write a will as the Richmond Town lady did. She succeeded. It is a staircase. Every will is custom made. No two wills are similar. It depends upon individual wishes. Properties are different. Wishes are different. Needs are different. Pradeep, he made a will. Very clever fellow. He wanted to save money. He took the will, in respect of his property. Then at home, he deleted his name and replaced with his wife. Lack of experience. By merely replacing his name with his wife, he did not pass on his wife's properties to him. Because he did not take care that he had to change the properties also. The first will he made, he was in respect of his property, his will. But he only changed the name of his wife, replaced his name with his wife, and the purpose failed. I met one person, very rich person, when I was in Abu Dhabi. He had wife, 4 children, 1 daughter and 3 sons. Very rich. In Mumbai, he had purchased 4 different apartments. I had gone to Abu Dhabi and Dubai to make a presentation to KE members there regarding wills. He was also present. Then I spoke with him. I mentioned him, have you made a will? He said, Robin, I don't want a will. Everything is safe. Then he went on to explain. See, I have purchased 1 house in joint name, myself and my wife. I have 5 properties, Robin. The second house, myself and my daughter in joint name. Like that. Third house, himself and son. And another 3 sons. Do you know what happens if he dies? His wife will not get the entire house. Nor his children get the entire house. The moment he dies, at present he owns only 50% share in each of the houses. Not full share. Take for example the first house jointly owned by himself and his wife. When he dies, he gets only 50% share. Out of that 50% share, his wife is entitled to 1/3 share. And 4 children are entitled to divide the 2/3 share amongst them. Now the second house, which he jointly owns with his daughter. When he dies, he, out of 50%, wife is entitled to 1/3. Then another 2/3 has to be distributed among the children. Goes on. If they want to develop, if they want to sell after his death, all these people have to join together and sign the deeds. That's why little advice from an expert is absolutely necessary. Mrs. Verghese will download it from Google. She has 2 daughters. And the will contains only 2 paras. First para, all my assets, movable and immovable, bequeathed to my 2 daughters in the 60-40 ratio. Mention the name. 60% to the eldest daughter, 40% to the second daughter. all my assets, movable and immovable. Next paragraph, he says, whatever residual clause, it goes to the daughters. Third para, I bequest to 10 persons who had served me during my lifetime. She has given a list of 10 persons. Where is the money? In the first para itself, she has given all 100% to her daughters. Where is the money to bequeath to the person who served her? That's a mistake a person makes by downloading from her. Then, another major Ramdas, he has made a joint will. He advised his son also to make a joint will. Then his son approached me. I explained to him the consequences of making a joint will. Is joint will safe? Joint will, as the name says, it is signed by two persons. Normally and usually, it is made by a couple. Now, let us take, for example, Adrian and Lavina. I think it was Adrian who laughed loudly a little while ago, if I'm not wrong. Let's take an example. Adrian and Lavina make a joint will. What happens to this will? Who will die first? Will come into force when a person dies. Until then, they can change it. They have the liberty to change that will, modify it, as long as both of them are alive. Now, when one person dies, the other person will hold that will. She can't give effect to the will. She can't change the will. Nothing can be done with that will. For example, now take for example, Adrian's will. Adrian dies first. The will come into force so far as Adrian is concerned, but it can't be given effective. Lavina will have to hold it. Now Adrian has given benefit in that will to a charity. Adrian is no more. Lavina can't change the will. Charity has vanished. What should happen to that? Now, Adrian has made that will. In that will, he wishes certain amount to be given to a certain person. That person badly needs that money. Yes, will has not come into force. Lavina can give that money to that person. Now, Adrian has made in that will, or both, that's it, their will, together will, joint will, both of them aside. They have given some amount, a good amount, to one person. When Adrian dies, the will be disclosed, maybe disclosed. That person comes to know about that he is going to get the money. Then there may be pressure on Lavina or threat to Lavina's life because the other person gets the money. Or that person may disrespect Lavina, may not listen to her or create problems to her. What will happen? That will, joint will come into force only on the death of both of them. After the death of Adrian, during the lifespan of Lavina, Lavina will be holding a dead body. When you have chest pain, would you rush to a dentist or an ENT surgeon? You know the answer. I came across another will recently. She was inspector in income tax department. She had gone to a lawyer. Only two properties are mentioned there, two houses. Nothing else. She has jewelry and other, nothing is mentioned, only two properties. And the properties are given to one to the son, and that is life interest of the husband, and the property of the daughter. Now, to that will, husband is the attesting witness. Her husband, who is 76 years old, if she dies early, she will not get any benefit from that, being an attesting witness. This is despite going to a lawyer. So remember what I said earlier. go to a proper person whom you have trust. Thank you very much for listening to me. And Viren.
Yes, Mr. Robinson.
Yeah. I'll close my presentation.
Thank you, Mr. Robinson, for your thoughtful insights into this topic. I'm going to trouble you for a few more minutes.
Trouble?
I have some interesting questions for you. To all our viewers present here, I'm sorry if I'm unable to ask all your questions due to the time permitting.
You can send me those questions I will send my answers to KCA. They can distribute them. We will solve it.
Yes, yes.
Yes. You can send all those questions to me. Hilma, will you agree to that? Any number of questions. I have retired and have some time.
I'm sure you're a very busy man with all the...
Don't worry about it. You go to the court, I don't go to the court. And your courts are closed now.
Yes, yes. So, Mr. Robinson, the first question that we have from one of our viewers is, how do we know that it is the last will? Will the will be registered somewhere of a person?
No, see, registration is an optional. Registration is an option. If he wants to register, he can register. If he doesn't want to register, it is not compulsory. Every will be mentioned as last will and testament. It will be signed not only by the testator, by two witnesses. You have to take it for that. You have to take it like that. There is no special seal and all. If you register it, and there will be a problem. If you want to change it, you have to again go to the court. Look at that IT inspector. Now they have registered it. It's a they will useless will. Person doesn't, harassment doesn't get any benefit. Now I have to go to the court, this one, substitute office, spend money for to cancel that way, this one. Then one more will. Once you register, then cancellation again register. Then later on you may have to go register it all. Yeah.
So the next question comes from another viewer. What happens if the person who made the will passes away and both the witnesses also pass away? Now, how do you prove that?
There are several cases there. It's a part of life. We have a limited lifespan. I come across a number of cases. You can approach the relatives of the witnesses. They'll be having signatures of those persons there. They may be having bank accounts. In the banks, there will be their signatures. And in the court, you can call those signatures of the bank or other documents and compare them. A number of cases are there and succeed in proving that those who were. And you can invite, you can request the relatives to come and depose, saying that this was my father's signature. I know about it. And my father told me that he had signed the will of such and such a person. I am aware of it.
Yes. The next question is, can property which is under litigation, can that property be willed?
Yeah, you can. You can will. But it will be subject to the litigation.
Litigation.
Whatever happens there, you need not wait for the litigation. Because today the litigation will go, you don't know. If you have the money, you can take it till Delhi in the Supreme Court. You need not wait till the case ends. Subject to the litigation, you can make it.
That is quite with the legal system in this country. So the next question is, can ancestral property, which applies to Christians, can that property be willed?
According to me, we have no ancestral property. So where Christians are concerned, the ancestral property doesn't apply to us. It's only to Hindus. Whatever property Viren, you have got from your dad, he may have given you. That's your property, Viren. It doesn't become ancestral property. That's only for Hindus, four generations without any partition.
Yes. So the next question, the next question comes. Can I mention multiple executors in my will? One executor passes away. Can I mention another executor in my will?
You can have joint executors. But remember, there should not be any fight between them while giving effect. You can make a close ratio. If you want to make a will, you can think of making your wife as an executor, and to assist her, you can authorize her to take the assistance of another expert, another lawyer, and to help her in giving effect to the will. Viren, I'll be sending you a legal bill later on.
Definitely, definitely. I hope it's not too expensive. The next question that we have, Mr. Robinson, is that does a codicil also have to be registered? A codicil is an addition to a will. Does that document have to be
registered? If you register a will, if you want to make any changes, the subsequent changes will have to be registered. Otherwise, if you don't register the will, codicil need not be registered.
Yes. Another question comes from Ms. Rodriguez. What is the procedure to register a will in case I want to register my will?
The procedure is same. For the writing of the will, same, whether you register or not register it. When you register it, you have to take the will and the witnesses to the sub-register office. Witnesses come along with you. Their sub-registrar will inquire you. And in the presence of the sub-registrar, the witnesses have to sign, you will sign. Later on, all of them will be photographed. Other procedure is the same. There is no difference.
Yes. Another question comes from one of our viewers. It says that in the bank accounts, the nominees are mentioned in the bank accounts. However, the legal heirs that are being mentioned in the will, who will have the right?
No. One second. Repeat that question.
The question is that in the bank accounts, a nominee is mentioned. However, in the will, a legal heir is mentioned. Who gets the right in the bank account?
One. In the will, if the proceeds in the bank account are given to somebody under the will, the nominee will not get it at all. The person to whom the proceeds in the bank account are given under the will, that person will be entitled to the amount.
Yes. I think another question has come from Mr. Selva Kumar. I think it's a follow-up question to your answer, where he asks, if no inheritance law applies for Christians, does it mean that the sons do not have right over the grandfather's property? I think that answers it in itself, because there's no ancestral property with regard to Christians. So a grandson has no right over the grandfather's property with regard to Christians. I think it applies only to Hindus.
You answered that one. Next.
Yes. Another question comes from Mr. Lobo. Can a registered will be superseded by a later unregistered will?
No. Once you register anything, if you have to change it, you have to register it. You can't supersede it by writing another will. If you don't register it, it will have no value.
Okay, I think Mr. Robinson, those are all the questions that have been asked by our viewers today. Hilma, is there any other questions that need to be asked?
I can see a few questions here.
Yeah. And plus, there are some hands raised.
One or two hands raised here also.
For those whose hands are raised, kindly type it in the chat box so that we can answer them. Ms. Fernandez, I think the question that you had asked, it's a little big for me to ask Mr. Robinson at this moment. I think it's better if you send an email to the KCA with regard to your query, because it'll need a little more in-depth analysis of your question to Mr. Robinson. Another question that has been asked by our viewers is, if both the husband and wife are joint owners of a property, should they both make a joint will for the property, or can they make separate wills for the property?
I have explained to you the consequences of making a joint will.
Yes.
It's better if they make separate wills, independent wills,
yes,
because they will have to will away only their portion of the property, their share of the property.
That share of the property.
In that joint will. So this is common. It's common.
Yes. Now, another question is, I have a registered will. How do I go about cancelling that will?
You have to write cancel. It's a legal document, another deed of cancellation. Mention in the registered will, I want to cancel this one. It's a simple, about 3-4 paragraphs.
Yes,
deed
sir.
Of cancellation of the will.
Another question.
Mentioning the details of the first earlier will and saying that I hereby intend to cancel earlier with, and submit that one to the sub-registrar. There, the fee is very much less, nearly 200 rupees or so for cancellation.
The next question is, does every page of the will have to be signed by the person making the will?
Yes. Yes. Witnesses need not sign every page. It's sufficient if the witness signed at the end. But if the testator desires, he can request the witness to sign every will. But testator has to sign each and every page of his will. That is to avoid any complaint in later that certain pages have been changed, interpolated.
Another place. On what grounds can I challenge a will?
Mental, he was not in a mental condition, not sound mind. He was under intoxication. There's a fraud played upon him.
Like another, those girls. Another question. Can I nominate my son or daughter to be the executor of the will?
Yes. It's not nominated, it's appointing.
Appointing, yes.
Yeah, appointing. Son and daughter, they can. And they can inherit, they can get some bequests or devices under the will.
Mr. Ishwar Kapsi, I think your question has already been answered by our speaker of your question with regard to the nominees and legal heirs, where it has been clearly stated that the legal heirs would get a right in the property over the nominee. Next question, do I need a doctor certificate to prove I was of sound mind when I made the will?
It is not compulsory, but depending upon the circumstances, depending on the circumstances, situations, and the age of the person, the advisor may suggest. I have done to a person. I request one person, took him to a doctor, obtained a certificate that he is of sound mind. Because in his case, it was a Hindu will, he had married 4 times. And continue to maintain relations with all the earlier wives. Lots of property he had. And when he wanted to make the will, he was meeting me. There were people behind him, watching him where he was going. If he entered from the front door of the hotel, he used to run out from the back door and to meet me. That was the case. When I came, I took him a doctor. He was of sound mind. But I did want to take a precaution.
Mr. Chetan Kamath, your question with regard to, in the absence of a will, do the deposit amounts go to the nominees rather than the legal heirs in deposit receipts? I think we have already covered that topic. The next one comes from Mr. Fernandez. If I tear away and throw my registered will, is there any consequences?
But it doesn't affect the effectiveness of that will, because it is registered. A registered copy is available to anybody there. Anybody can apply, his person. He may tear it away, the copy, but if another person, his relatives, inheritors, others can obtain a certified copy because it is registered.
I think those are all the questions that... Ms. Doris, I think your question, can siblings be appointed as executor of the will? Yes, they can be appointed, as has been stated by Mr. Robinson. There's no bar on appointing your siblings, your brother or sister, or anybody to be an executor of the will. The next question, what happens to your Facebook accounts, your Gmail accounts, your LinkedIn accounts, and all your online accounts when you pass away? Who has the rights to them?
The person can include them in his will, digital assets. It's possible. I have done it for a couple of persons, bequeathing digital assets.
Yes. That's great.
But passwords all have to be kept secret. It will not be mentioned in the will. It will be kept in a secret place, but known to some persons. Another thing is that when persons make a will, have at least 2 copies. Let one copy be with you and the copy with another person. Sometimes some people make only 1 copy of the will, keep it in the locker, And if the death takes place, nobody will know, be knowing where the locker key is there, in which locker it is, and it may be opened long after. See, same thing happened to this Shivaswamy. Shivaswamy had donated his eyes. He had donated his eyes. I can't disclose to it anybody. He signed the will. I was present when he signed the will. Then I came out. He died. The moment he died, from the hospital itself, his daughter informed me. My uncle, daddy, Tirodhar uncle. They meet asked, Nimma daddy, on will maadidru gotta? Yes, uncle, nani helidare, nani gottu. I kept quiet. After 1 month, when I went to the puja, there a person, his driver came and gave me a cover. I asked him, what is this? Illa sahabru helidru, nimme kuda kelidru. Yena HKM nimage. The cover was not opened. Shivaswamy wanted his eyes to be donated. And these people had not seen it. Nobody had read it. And the will was with the driver, trusted person. See what he lost. On account of the illiteracy of all these persons, two persons who could have seen the light of the light were deprived of the same.
The next question we have is, if I write my will on an email and send it to somebody, is that valid?
I have told you about the attestation, signing, two witnesses. If you send it by email, where is the this? It can't be a legal document.
Yes. If there are no further questions from our viewers, I think we can conclude the session. Any other questions may please be directed to the KCA email. Mr. Robinson, on behalf of everyone here today, I thank you for taking the time to speak with us on this very important topic. I'm sure that our viewers here have learned a lot and a great deal. We hope that you would be involved in our future webinars on all our legal topics. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for joining us. Over to the
Thank you very much. I'm leaving.
Thank you, Mr. Robinson and Mr. Viren Perez, for your session.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.